Reviews. We've got Everard's Shut That Door and Away. I don't know how many of you know what I'm on about. You know, how many of you kind of remember old Larry Grayson? He used to be absolutely fantastic years ago. One of them, those comedians that just could give a look to camera and it told a thousand jokes, you know. And was never, he was never kind of like a offensive and that. He was one of those that the kids could watch, you know. I used to be a kid watching him and that, you know, and the kids could watch, and was just, he was an absolute legend, fantastic comedian, and one of those that when they die, they kind of, you always feel a massive space has been emptied and that, and the world has got a little bit heavier on your shoulders now. And unfortunately, I don't think there's enough good comedians kind of filling their place, you know. There are some good comedians in there out there, there really are, but they're either morose like Stuart Lee's and that. It's still good, you know, but a bit morose. You kind of leave things feeling, you know, the world is an heavier place. And that's good sometimes because it makes a point and makes a statement and that, as well as making you laugh. But I'm going off the remit, I'm sorry. There you go, there's two little things in it because I've opened it with my pen knife again. I've been slicing myself with and everything. Right, this is Morrison's. They've got their own livery on there, they've got three others as well. I think they've got three others, they may have some more, let me know if they have. But they've got three others that I have found anyway. And Black Sheep, Marsden's. Everard, Shut That Door, and all that. He used to have different names for different characters that was his friends and all that business, you know, imaginary friends, I think. Maybe they was on his circuits and things when he was in the pubs and clubs and that. But, you know, there was... I'm trying to think of some of the names. Everard was one. Slack Alice and things like that. It was just fantastic, really was. As he said... He said, stiff down here today and yesterday. And the day before, I was all stiff down that side. He said, I can't wait until tomorrow. Right, sorry. For a dark ale, it's kind of just a mahogany. Maybe a deep mahogany at best, but it's a mahogany. So let's give it a twist. Let's give it a sniff and see what I can tell you about it. Interesting. Does it tell you about any hops or anything? Oh, I doubt it. Now, there's an interesting thing. It says, forget claret, forget Chianti. This ruby red ale is the thing to serve with a slap-up meal. Right, so they're talking about Chianti and claret, and then they're talking about a slap-up meal. Okay, carry on with it. It is a rich silky texture, and it has a rich silky texture and a fruity flavour that's not dissimilar to a punchy New World wine. Okay, I don't know who's written this, but okay, we'll go with it. It's got the oomph to stand up to the meatiest pie and the stinkiest cheese, so swap the grape for the grain next time you invite your mates around for a meal. You'll never look back. Mm. Try it with Sunday roast beef, or to round off a meal with a really punchy British cheese board. Okay, well, we'll see. Let's have a little sniff. Getting floral notes, you are actually getting grapey notes, so they may have something like a grapey sort of hop in there, I don't know. Maybe they're mixing something caramelly with a Nelson Sauvin or something that give it a grapey edge in it. Maybe something Cascadey or something as well. This and Goldings possibly, but you got sort of you have got sort of slight berry edges on the nose. Not nowhere near as berry as it could be though. You got slight cranberry notes in the background, little berry edges. But you've got a lot of caramelly sort of notes in there. You've got a lot of biscuity notes. Tangerine notes, there's a blood orange notes. Something slightly floral, kind of almost Earl Grey tea, but not long. It's got not cardamom, but something floral, like rose watery sort of thing. Yeah, something slightly floral. Funny enough, if you don't shake it and you have a smell, you get a big biscuit note come up. Shake it and all the kind of fruity notes overtake. So, another discovery, sometimes give it a sniff before you shake and then shake and give it another sniff. You're discovering stuff all the time. I've had about 3 discoveries today. See, now I'm getting kind of digestive biscuits, little edges in them. And then the fruit kind of gallops over the top. Right, let's have a taste. Cheers, everyone. I'm not going down the kind of the red wine sort of things. This is, it tastes like a nice bitter or a nice kind of best bitter sort of thing. A dark ale. Yeah. I'm getting a kind of like a good best bitter. Nice bittery little finish notes. It is nice, you know. But the kind of the gumph, I think, lets it down because it's describing something else when it's good at what it does. And what it does is a nice little kind of quintessentially British best bitter. Excuse me. All of these beers have been quite burpy. So yeah, that kind of pumped up with gas and everything else, and then, you know, bottled up and it. But there's, like I've said before, you get like real ale, and you can have poxy real ale, and you can have good real ale, and you can have kind of pasteurised poxy and not poxy, and you can have pumped up good ones, great ones, fantastic ones, poxy ones, and all sorts. You know, you can have all sorts of different categories of carbonation and different categories of all sorts of different things that are good, bad and indifferent. And that's not a bad one. It's actually nice. It's actually quite nice. But it's kind of gone outside what's described on the bottle. Now, I've made the mistake of reading the bottle and getting preconceived notes. Now, preconceived notes on bottles are never a good idea. You either get described a bottle, a beer that's going to be woo, and you kind of get let down, or you get the opposite. You know, I think that a beer should either, if it doesn't talk to you itself, then it's got nothing to say, and the label shouldn't be saying it. You tell us what ingredients there are, so we know what to expect in the next ones a little bit. And you'd be surprised how quickly people learn if they see just a list of hops, 1, 2, 3 or whatever. They'll go, oh, I really enjoyed that one with so-and-so in last time, you know. And they'll be looking for that next time, you know. So, to sum this up. Right, it is nice. It is very nice. It's not way like that, but it is very nice. Once you kind of, I've got a short memory, once I start forgetting about what they've described it as. Roast beef, yeah, you could eat it with roast beef dinner. Really punchy cheese balls, I wouldn't go really punchy. Kind of medium-y sort of punchy cheese balls. Don't go for big hefty Stiltons and things like that. But sort of medium cheese ball again. If you're going for big Stiltons, get yourself a big beer. Something like, I've never found a better food pairing than Stilton and O'Hanlon's Brewers Reserve. I think it's O'Hanlon's nowadays, but Brewers Reserve. I don't know if they're still doing it. I think they are. But that was a superb food pairing, the best ever. And I'm hoping that the new sort of governors ain't messed it up, as usually happens with takeovers. But anyway, that is lovely. That's nice. But don't read the label. So, go and get it. Drink it along with me. And you tell me what you think. Am I wrong? Tell me. Am I right? Tell me. You know, like it or whatever, you know. If you like what I'm kind of talking about, like it. If you don't, just say. Tell you're an idiot. You're a bum till. I don't really get into all this kind of likes, dislikes, and everything else, but I think that what happens is that it kind of affects the kind of your positioning on the searches and things like that. And if you're enjoying what a reviewer does, that he's telling the truth and things like that, then press likes on all their reviews and that. I ain't saying mine, you know. I'm just saying anyone's. Because it gives a bigger voice to guys like us that are speaking the truth rather than a paid advert. If you get, and you do get occasional, very rare, but you do get occasional reviewers that anyway, right, so I shall just get on with it. Cheers, everyone. Bottoms up. Chin, chin. Cheers. Lovely. Cat's moving. He's going to start meowing in a minute. Bye. See you in the next one. Don't be late. With